Now see. Yes, let's see that one after this buttons all created. After we are going to see that one. So we have created button one, and then we have to do copying this button one, and we have to paste over here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So change the variable names here like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then what we have to do here, we have to change the text here, where the text here, the text we have to check like 9, it should return button 9, button 8 should be returning 8, and 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2, that's it. And then we have to change this rows and column positions, like so 1, 0 it is correct, 1, 1, and then we have to change 1, 2, and then for the next row like 2, 0, 2, 1, it's 2, 0, two, one here, and then so not 2 here, it's 3, 0, 3, 1, and 3, 2. Let's run this and see what's going to be happen here. See here, we got a screen like this. So these buttons are working, but this button contents are not going to display here in this screen. Why? Because it is going to take the from keyboard itself. We are not going to have the, we are not going to done like this. We have to take the content from the buttons itself. So let's see how we are going to do that one. So for doing such operation, we have to define a function here. We have to define a function that should be clicking buttons. So I am naming it as click. So click off. Which number we are going to pass, that number should be right over there. So after clicking this one, we have to create a global variable called operator. Let's call that one. And then what we have to do, we have to append this operator equals to operator plus string of that number. That number here, it should be number or should be there. Number. So we are converting that number into string, and we are going to add it to the operator. And then we have text here. We have created a text variable. Here text string variable. We have to set that to the screen. Set that to the screen using set operator. We are going to pass arguments like operator over here. So and we defined a function, and we have to make a call using a function call in the buttons function. This is an invisible function. Let's write here command that is equals to lambda function. We are going to use lambda here, lambda of click. We are calling the click number should be 1 here. So whenever we are going to call this number, it should rate 1. So lambda lambda using this lambda is should syntax we have to create a colon here. Whenever we are going to call the lambda function, we have to make the type of colon there. See what happens by clicking this one here. See the output is here, like it is printing one. So when we are going to press two, it is not going to work. Why? Because we are not calling the button two. That's why it is not calling. So we have to copy this command line here and we have to paste this over there. We can make anywhere, we can place this command anywhere in this comments, but we can, for our specific to seeing specific, I am making this one here only. After the screen, comma should be there, and then here should be comma. Here we missed a comma. Comma. Making function call to each and every button present in our screen. After making all this, let's see what's going to be happen. One. Whenever we are going to call, press this button 2, it is going to write 1. Why? Because in the function call of the button 2, we wrote the click of 1. So we have to change this one. We have to change it 2. And we have to change this 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So I think this all set happened. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4, 5, 2, 9. So whatever you are going, whichever button you are going to press, that data is going to visible in this screen. That's it, guys. If you have any doubts regarding this screen, how to create screen and how to get the number functions over this or here, if you have any doubts regarding this, please comment me in the comment section. That's it, guys. Thank you.